Hey friends, it's Brian, and I'm going to be working on my 1990 F-350 IDI diesel today, working on the battery cables. So I was waiting on some stuff to come in, and it has come in. I will post links to the wires, the wrap, some of the tools I'm using, including this So I needed this wire to replace this one because this is some sketchy ass wiring, just, and the truck unfortunately is full of it. So without further ado, let's start recreating this wire. I need a wire strip, I'll be right back. Number 12. Found a eBay seller called Wire Barn that had reasonable shipping charges and quality wire, and so far they're living up to what they promised. Let me get the terminal size sorted out and I'll be right back. Alright, so I've got some heat shrink connectors and I've got some wire fly crimpers. I'll put a link to this stuff in the description, so if you need it, you can quickly and easily find it. The jaws are calibrated to the actual fittings. There's no universal. All right, there we go. We've got a nice solid crimp there. And now we need to heat shrink it. Alright, so we've got a nice, well, almost. Okay, so at this point we've got a nice heat shrink terminal on here, so we'll measure the length and get it cut. So it should be about here. I think I might actually just leave this and get it trimmed when I get it in place, because it needs to be right and I don't like the way it was. Yeah, I think that's what we'll do. So I have some piece of tape that is specifically for vehicles. I want to leave a little bit more down here and I'm just going to use this to kind of end my wire. Oh, I need scissors. So high quality automotive tape does not rip. So now we have a cable assembly that has some abrasion resistance and some extra length to get to the solenoid where it needs to go. And we're going to set this off to the side and work on the ground cables. The precision wire cutter here. Probably not the best way to do that, but I'm working with the tools that I have. Got some plugs. Two off, yes. Better habit of putting my heat shrink tubing on first. Thank you. So that's one. Let me go set it on the truck and I'll start making the other one. Time for another precision trim here. Thank you. So that's ready to go to the truck. All right, so we're finally going to start to hook up the battery on this. Should be on the frame, but this is going to work. These air conditioner lines are definitely in the way. Perfect, but good. This is really not a good spot for this. but this is where it goes for now. I'll work on relocating it some other time. Many reasons that's not a good place. Yeah, this was wrong size, improperly crimped. So many things wrong. Just not a good spot for this. Oh well, this will work. So that's just on there. Still need to make a connection to here on both sides. And I need to remake this sorry excuse for a wire. I guess this could come off. Let me find this. Three-eighths and nine-sixteenths. 5/8 either. Probably half. Let me go find a half inch. Alright, so it is a half inch. Wait, that's torqued properly. So let's go remake this. Let's see. So this needs to go from here across to there. We'll just make it the same length. Okay, so got some number six wire, quality wire. Do not have one of the ends that I need, so we're just gonna make the best of it. You know, I have plenty of this. I'm gonna go remeasure this on the truck. First, I'm gonna put the end on. Thank you. looking for that. I measured on the truck. Alright, so I measured what I thought was the appropriate length. Now I've got to find the mark I made. There it is. And I do not have the other end of the fitting that I need, so I have to pause. All right. Okay. Yeah, that's all I can do for now. All right. So we're gonna route the starter cable back here. Figure out where it came through. Because I absolutely trust nothing underneath the diesel engine, I am putting a drop of Loctite or thread lock, because it's not actually the Loctite brand, but I'm gonna put some thread locker on this. Thank you.
just don't like the cable touching anything. But I guess it is what it is. Solenoid wire on here. And I do have a lock washer for this. Unfortunately, I'm going to take my gloves off because I have to do this by feel. There's that lock washer again. This thing really is choked. No telling where that washer went. Actually, I see it right there. Let me get a screwdriver. Well, I think it finally fell in the crack that's under here. So I'll have to go find another washer that's that size. Motherfucker. Alright, so this is a 1032 nut. I don't think I'll stick my fingers up through there again. Really? Insurance, I brought two of them. I just can't. So that's the problem. Well, for whatever reason, it's not going to go on. Thank you. So that's started. Now let's see if we can get it on here. So this is a nylon lock nut, so it shouldn't cause nearly as many issues once it's tightened. But my left hand is falling asleep. For a minute. That gives me a chance to look around and see what else is rusted and fucked up on this truck. Yes, there's a lot of shit on this truck that needs attention, but that's what I bought it for. It's a project. It's even turning. Don't seem to keep getting anywhere. Thank you. shouldn't be this hard. Alright, well, I think I'm going to take the other bolt off so I can see. I didn't expect to have to do this. So there's a piece of plastic, there's like a plastic separator that's blocking the fucking socket. Let me go get a hand wrench and see if I can get to it that way. Clearly, this is something that should be attached before the starter goes in. All I gotta rest my hands again. Making progress. It's almost there. It's just tedious. There it is. What a pain in the ass. All right. A little more time with my hand next to an unknown spider. I hate spiders. Well, I don't hate them. I just have a healthy respect for them. Anything that makes its living by injecting digestive juices into its prey, sucking it out, is something to be respected in my book. There we go. Seems pretty solid. That's good. That's good. All right. I think we're done down here finally. Fucking A. All right. So, loosen that. Let me go get some gloves. I'll be back. Be right back. Alright, so we're gonna undo this first. Pull this cable up here, get it out of the way. Thank you.
get there.
So this cable needs to come over here, probably about right there. I'm not real happy with the routing of this. That's better. So I'm gonna go get some tools and make some changes. All right, so we know we've got one there. And I'm gonna bring this up about right there. Gotta get cutters. At this point, we're good, except I want to do a little test, and that is going to require that I tighten a couple bolts. Very suboptimal. And we are 130% not ready to run this truck, but I want to see if it turns over because I've done a lot of work. And it should turn over at this point. Turning over. So we're not going to try to start it. We just wanted to see that. So what this tells us is that starter solenoid works and the battery wiring is all good and we've got a charge in the batteries, and that's all I'm going to do for tonight. I want to get the ground from here to the frame, and I want to get some other things taken care of before I try and do a start. Well, actually, you know what? Heck with it. Let me play with it for a second. I'll be right back. We can spin it over. It shouldn't start because I don't have power to the dash, so that shouldn't power up. I want to answer some questions.
I need to get power from here to there, and I don't have the right connector. So that's as far as I can take it tonight, but it's doing what it should be doing. So that's encouraging. That suggests, and let's see if the solenoid works. No, solenoid does not seem to work. So applying power to this side of it should have grounded it through the starter. So I'll have to figure out what's going on with that. Again, you know, this wiring is a hot mess. That probably shouldn't be loose. I just have no idea what the fuck is going on over here. Whoever had this truck before played I Can Mechanic, and clearly they can't. So I will have to piece together one lousy step at a time what's going on and get it running. And then it'll be a fun work truck for me. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hopefully you find this as motivating as I do, knowing that at least I've got it to the point where the batteries will turn over the truck. It has a bat's chance in hell of starting.